income perspective. So this comes from our research on everyday narratives of like migration and spelling the everyday in texts. So to begin with, in the seminal text Mourning and Melancholia, Sigmund Freud described melancholia as similar to mourning in terms of the environmental factors that cause the emotion. In other words, as the reaction to the loss of a loved person or to the loss of some abstraction which has taken the place of one, such as one's country, liberty, an ideal, and so on. Distinct from sadness, melancholia can be characterized particularly by the feeling of loss. Whereas mourning is a healthy reaction to loss that is overcome, melancholia is the persistence of feelings of loss that in some way cannot be fully understood. In Freud's terms, understood by both the person suffering and the wider society. In Freud's terms, the melancholic cannot see clearly what it is that has been lost, and it is all the more reasonable to suppose that the patient cannot consciously perceive what he has lost either. This indeed might be so even if the patient is aware of the loss which has given rise to his melancholia, but only in the sense that he knows whom he has lost, but not what he has lost in him. It is this sense of not quite comprehending what has been lost that is the preoccupation for much literature.